wink at this a little bit more and realize I was out of focus here. Sorry about that. Let me bring it down a little bit. All right, so what was his name? Jacob? Is that what you said? I guess she is out of the room. Anyways, we have a little something here by Rasa Easels. I hope I'm saying that right. Rasa. Out of St. Louis, Missouri. They were kind enough to send us a little package of their stuff. This is not a paid review. This is not a sponsor or anything. They just, we were interested and they wanted to know, and we said sure. So this came today. Let's take a look at what we got here. All right. Faber Cast. Do you guys say Castle or Castle or what do you guys say? I just say awesome markers. Look at that. They sent us three different colors. These look like one of my favorite YouTubers, street muralist named Kipto. That's like his colors. Pretty cool. All right, so look how awesome this little easel is. Let's try to figure it out here. I guess these are the degrees of your angle, I would assume. Comes with, this one came with two pads here. And it is attached to that. I see. So check that out. It's attached, your pad and your easel. So I guess that's kind of cool. Like, you don't want to be without it. You'll never forget it, that's for sure. All right. So I think what you do is you lift this up, put this here, and whatever angle, you put it in this little slot and you lock it in. Move this out of the way. And there you have it. Nice little, let's see, maybe we could get a little different angle here. So you can kind of see what I'm looking at. There you go. How fun is that? And like I said, you can, like, if you want, you can have it all the way to the top. So I guess if you're trying to sketch somebody across the way. Let's see, I got a nice little sharpened pencil right here. You have to check this out. Hold on, I'm going to show you what this pencil sharpener does. I just got this the other day. Sorry guys, I have to show you this pencil sharpener. It's one of those super long, like, it's not just a typical pencil sharpener. Like, if you have a pencil and it's just a regular sharpen, you know, check this guy out. That. Compared to a, and look at this, it didn't take, like, I thought it was going to take like a whole bunch down, like, but it just takes it down to the lead. Pretty cool. And this is not a paid advertisement. I don't even know what brand this is. I just got it from off Amazon. So if you're watching this brand, I love this sharpener. And you plug it in, you have to unplug it when you use it, charge it. All right, so let's check this little sturdy. It feels kind of sturdy. Very nice, very well made, very nice craftsmanship. Very classy looking. Very easy to adjust if you're just ready to go on the fly. Got a little attachment there. How fun is that? And it's very lightweight. I mean, obviously it's not meant for roughhouse. I wouldn't use it as a bicycle ramp, but it does the job. Let me see this. They gave me two. This one feels a little rougher. See, that is two different. That's very smooth. This one has a little texture, so this one might be good for charcoal. And I do have some charcoal right here with me. Made in St. Louis. What? By artists, for artists. Oh, this is, I apologize. This is their actual paper. I just thought it came with a pad. But these are definitely different. Let me see this. Sorry about that, guys. I didn't realize this was your paper. I guess I could probably pay attention. Let's see here. It is mixed media paper, drawing paper. 15 sheets, 24 sheets, 100 lb. This is 187 by 300, so 160. GSM, what is that? I'm one of those artists that really have never paid attention to numbers or stuff like that. I'm a self-taught. I go with what I like. Let's see what we got here. This is just drawing, right? So let's see what we got with a pencil here. We'll do the paper, then we'll do the easel there, the one on the easel. So let's see. What should we draw here? Let's just do some lettering. Let's do Rasa. Probably should have warmed up a little bit, but from what it feels like, this paper is pretty smooth paper. Like normally you could feel it, like drawing paper. Man, this is nice for a pencil. Like it goes on really smooth. Like, I'm not used to reviewing stuff. I just normally just will take it and use it. But they were kind enough to send this to us, so if my reviews are a little unorthodox, I do apologize. I'm new at this, so one of the artists that I kind of just kind of go with it. If I don't like it, I won't use it. I'm not gonna say I like it and use it just because they sent it to me. We're kind of honest with our reviews if we do get people that ask us to review their stuff. Mainly that's the resin side. And Erica normally does that, so. She is not here, as you can see. So, I'm really digging this paper. Like, I like it. It reacts really well with this pencil. Look at that. Man, that's like... Like, I like it because it's like you're using like the softest lead, and this is just a regular pencil. Like, I'm really digging it. They make their own pad. This is their pad of paper.
It's their own paper?
Yeah.
Oh, it does say Rasa.
Yeah, I didn't even realize that.
It looks so airbrushed on there. Like,
it's
how
very
faded
soft.
It is. What are you doing, little bean? What are you doing? What's he doing? What are you doing?
This is some General's Charcoal 2B. It's another thing I don't really pay attention to. I'll pick up a charcoal pencil and mark it, and if it's dark, I love to use it. If it's not, then I probably won't, unless I'm kind of just sketching with it. A little different with charcoal. I'm used to charcoal, you know, spreading out a little bit easier, but then again, I wasn't really pushing hard on the charcoal until now, and now it's I like it. It's very soft paper. Let's see what this does. I know I'm supposed to be reviewing the easel, but it's one of those things where you sit down, like if you're at a museum and they have like a little drawing section for like kids, and you're like, I think I'm going to sit down and doodle. You just kind of get into it. I always do that. It's because it takes me back to when you first start doodling, when you first know, like, that's what you want to do, that this is what you want to do, because you do it all over your papers or all over your walls at home or wherever you want to doodle. This is fun. This is reacting really well with this. Wow, that looks horrible. What is this? I'm looking at it on film. On film. Tell how old I am. All right. Horrible. Anyways, there's that. All right, back to the easel. Boom. Bada boom. Bada boom. I guess that's it, right? That's how you do it. Unless I'm doing this backwards and you do it like this. So people can see it, I imagine. Nope, because the pad of paper is on this side. You can't. Yeah, you know, can't do that, obviously, unless you turn this around. Which, obviously, then the pad is backwards. But this thing is up here. And how cool are all these little things? You know what? I do think. But this is the bottom, because this is kind of like tacky. And I don't think there's, oh, there is one over there. There's two right here too. So I'm guessing that is the bottom. I don't know. But the pad of paper would be upside down though. Sorry about that. See?
Okay. Or it even tells the degrees on the back, so yeah. That's the proper way, because it has, like, readable degrees right there.
So you, let's lift this up. So you open your pad first. Swing this back, so you expose your paper. I don't mind painting this low. We're drawing. Let's see what it feels like if you're just like, have it just straight up. I'm guessing you would do this if you were sitting on a desk. You'd be drawing something in front of you. If you were just doodling, you'd probably want it just down. Or at a slight angle. That's fun. We'll try to use these. Let's use these markers that they got. You got a small tip here. And like a brush tip. Oh yeah, it is. That's fun. Alright, let's try this. Hold on, let's go with this lighter, and then we're going to outline that stuff with that. All right, let's see here. Whoa, you push down on it and you get a lot of ink. These are pretty nice. I don't know why I just did that. That does not look right. That. That is fun. Let's see here. Just draw with just the fine point of this brush. I guess it's a brush tip. I'm not sure here. And quite a bit of ink comes out of these when you push down.
Do you have to hold your hand there, or is that just preference?
I don't know. I just do it. I think because I might worry that it's going to move, but I don't feel like it's moving. But I think I just to
it's
have
just
something
preference
stable.
For steady.
You know, I guess. That. These are fun markers. Although you probably could just take that other marker, the original one, and just darken that in. Or you can probably just fade that. Oh, you can. Is that what these are for? I don't know, that's fun. This is a nice little easel. It's like super sturdy. these little grippers. They have like little, I want to say it's leather or maybe it's rubber. These are super nice. This little grip ejection here. This is probably the only thing that I don't like about it, that you have to take this up and do this, but you gotta get a piece of paper, so you gotta get a piece of paper. This is really thick paper, too. I'm gonna try to use some charcoal on this here in a minute. See what this pen has to say. Is this turquoise? Cobalt green, 156. Until I come from an airbrush background. It's fun. You guys, I will sit here all day and just do it. And it stops when it's done, that sharpener. Oh yeah, this is definitely different paper, that's for sure. Sure, I'll get some thumbs down for this, but it's like I forget that I'm filming sometimes and I'm sketching and doodling and stuff. So I do apologize. And that's how you can tell I'm kind of getting into this product here, kind of forgetting what I'm doing and just enjoying what I'm doing. Try some color pencils. Super smooth. You can tell this has a little bit more texture, obviously, than the other one. Because it definitely, especially with these Prismacolor, it wears it down pretty quick. That's nice. You can actually paint, or you can draw on these markers. That's fun. Let's try this. Let's try some Posca pens on this paper. She's an old regular old Posca pen. it's like, it's giving me like some, see how it's kind of like, it's almost like holding on to the pin. I'm gonna try this pin with that other paper. Wow. Yeah, you just really gotta, you can't really try to go slow with these because you can feel it sticking to the paper there. Let's try it on this real quick. This is just the drawing paper, I believe, right? Yeah, this is the drawing paper. Let's make sure we get a fair test. Shake it up a little bit. Yeah, and I believe that was the paper that was on the end of that. It's a little different. That's a little different. It's like you forget that you're like, you have this little easel here. It's so comfortable. Very nice. Very nice little easel. Let's see how these guys react to each other. Because I think you're supposed to be able to get these Posca pins wet with either alcohol or water. I'm not sure. And they kind of blend, I think. We can do a 3D piece. I do have some 3D glasses, but I don't think that'll work. Well, I'm digging this. Here, this is a smoother paper. Let's see what this does. Let me draw on the Posca pin. Is there any difference? I'm not mad at this paper. I like it. I like the easel. I'm happy. What else we got? We got anything else we can draw in here with? We got this big old marker. We'll try to use this PBO. PBO. Just all running out. Marker. Not a fan of that gold at all. Does kind of dry fast. Let's see here. Yeah, this paper is this the one? Yeah, this is the thick paper. I'm just gonna kind of draw on it, and then I'm gonna draw back over what I drew to see how. I'll just do some lines and waste some time. Still not dry. Yeah, it definitely picks up the paper, but we're not doing a review on the paper. Paper's nice. I like it. The this easel, I like it. It's fun. I'd totally take it on the airplane with me. We are going to Kansas at the end of the month, then we're gonna go to Florida and Oregon to go see Stone Coat Countertops. We'll definitely be taking it with me on that trip. It looks like you can just kinda, does that kinda go with that? I guess you can just take this off and add it to this one. No problemo. Or you can just add it to that, if you like. But there you go. I would say 1 out of 10, 10 being awesome. I would say this is like a 9, only because of the kind of a distraction, and you kind of get in the way. It's kind of a, I don't know. It's just kind of a, I guess it's different. I guess you would get used to it. But all around, sturdiness, how light it is, the function. It's a great little easel. Look at that, and you're ready to go.
Pretty handy.
It is. Thanks, guys. I can dig it.